with the witch in captivity. And so the story continues. Hot on General Monkey's heels, Kutaro and Picarina stumbled into a steep, snowy mess of peaks called the Mean Moon Mountains. The last moonstone shard was all Kutaro needed to free his soul from its puppet prison and return to his home down on Earth. But our hero remained troubled as he climbed. He knew General Dragon and that clock had given the Moon Bear King control over every last child's soul. As Jack Frost nipped at the boy's fingers and toes, a cold and unshakable suspicion was starting to tug at his heart.
Wait, Your Highness! This is all a terrible mistake! Did I mention your fur looks especially lustrous?
Spare me the theatrics. I know exactly who you are.
Then get your grimy paws off me, Cuppy!
You thought you could pull a fast one on me, eh, Granny? But you were wrong! Once I've slapped down every last soul of every child on Earth, no moon goddess, not even the sun, will be able to stop me!
Kutaro still can! Calibrus chose him for a reason! The power of the four champions will see him through to his final task! He's going to restore the White Moonstone and bring light back to this realm, you poor stupid bear! I can't wait to watch him knock the stuffing out of you!
Shut up! Bring it on, Kutaro!
Bring him down, Kutaro!
You will never complete that moonstone, boy! Never!
Stand and fight, you coward!
At the very first glimpse of Kutaro, General Monkey ran as fast as
he could. I wonder if those icicles will fall. Careful you don't slip on the icy patches. Sure is wobbly. I hope it doesn't collapse. Oh, I hate high places. It's a Mrs. Yeti.
A what?
Whoa! Watch your step! We've got slippage! More Yeti! These guys are sound sleepers!
You know, some say that ski jumping began as a crude form of capital punishment.
Catch me!
With each passing moment, the Moon Bear King's power increased. The mountain was a stubborn, snowy sentinel, but Kutaro forced himself to trudge on. He had to complete the White Moonstone. He just had to. General Monkey was a crafty one. He knew he didn't have to fight Kutaro. He'd already won, just so long as he kept the last Moonstone shard out of reach. In the end, it wasn't brute strength or poison, but ingenuity that was giving Kutaro the most trouble.
Seriously, dude, what's up? You're gonna get sick.
As Kutaro climbed higher, the snow quickly turned to a
Okay, the wind switched direction.
Snowballs, great and small, began tumbling down the slope. A gift from Monkey?
Thank you, Secret Passage. I've had enough of winter trying to kill me. This is kind of fun. Did we just crash Santa's secret lair?
And you probably thought Christmas trees, stockings, and presents were an Earth thing.
They didn't finish decorating the tree. Lame.
A world of white stretched as far as the eye could see, but there was still no sign of General Monkey.
What the heck? How do we get up?
General Monkey's down escalator only went in one direction. Down. Into the abyss.
Is that a...
That's it! Keep it up! The crack's getting bigger! Almost there! Yes! Take that, popsicle!
Why not just give up?
Kutaro followed General Monkey right into the icy maw at the mountain's peak.
Say your prayers, Ape Face.
From the frigid peak into a scorching volcanic crater.
Extreme!
Ha ha ha!
reaches over 10 times the boiling point of water, a wooden puppet would be vaporized instantly.
Huh? Keep moving!
Kutaro weaved his way through the bursts of hot magma. Secret volcanic base designed to hide the secret rocket. I mean, what self-respect, but gravity was no match for Kutaro as he sheared through the stratosphere and up into outer space.
Well, that's all she wrote. We're stuck here forever.
This looks like fun. Can I play?
Do we look like we're playing? Wait, Ying Yang, how'd you get up here?
Forget that. The witch has been snatched by the Moon Bear King. You have to save her.
Save her? You're kidding, right? Why would we? She was gunning for the Moonstone right from the start. At least now, she won't get in the way of reviving the goddess and sending Kitaro home.
You know, I think you're missing the litter box for the droppings.
Hey, we've got 2 things to worry about. An ugly monkey and the Moonstone. Is the witch on that list? No! Now help us!
Fine, but hurry up and choose your transportation. You've got a monkey to pursue.
Can't do outer space.
Flying is for the birds.
This flashy one is the best. Now, monkey, we'll chase you out to the ends of the universe.
Good for you. I think this calls for a very special reward.
Octopuses! Space octopuses!
Actually, they're Martians.
Oh, they're hideous! Why are we always surrounded by ugly people?
On behalf of the Magical Theater, I would just like to apologize to all our guests for that completely inappropriate comment.
I wasn't talking about...
Kutaro had reached the asteroid belt. But that's strange. Isn't it supposed to be between Mars and Jupiter?
Hello, Land of Dreams! Let's be a little flexible here already! Oh, would you just surrender already?
Surrender this!
There are no ups and downs in outer space, only gravity. You might even say there's no such thing as left, right, forwards, backwards, yesterday, or indeed tomorrow.
It's squid! Martian squid!
No. Octopi are from Mars, but squid are from Venus. Welcome to the Warp Zone.
Whoa! Dramatic.
When Kutaro and Picarina were done warping, they re-emerged in a spaceship grave. These marvels of science.
Ew! More Martian and Venus. Nugent. Even their name is ugly.
They're lost in space. Have some compassion. All of our honored guests are encouraged to sit upside down as required to follow along.
Uh-huh. Right.
Warp engaged!
asteroid belt shall become the belt of your graves!
Is the monkey too scared to stand and fight? Okay, we're almost caught up! UFO. End of the line, Chip. It's game time.
I'm weary of dealing with you simpletons. The monkey gloves are off.
Look, Kitaro!
Watch that heat signature, Ares! Someone's locked onto you. It's okay, Scorpio. Let that aggression out.
Scorpio's rocking the scissors, too!
Shame in going in circles, Cancer. Heads up, Virgo! Explosive developments await. Now's your chance, Leo. Go ahead and pounce that boy! But you'll get where you need to be. When life gets hard, Capricorn, remember and cut yourself a break. Keep it real, Sagittarius, because he's about to fall for your arrows. You dead.
Same.
It was the moon bear.
Bad monkey!
He cast a spell?
I told you to let the moon work out its own kinks! But did you listen?
Okay, no, but I was worried about the moon goddess. She's always been so sweet to me, you know?
Yes, well, she had it coming. I warned her, beware the dark side of the moon! No never turn your back on the shadows!
But no, I want a balance. Light and dark and equal shares.
Yeah, that worked.
But Daddy, me and Kataro have worked so hard to find the Moonstone Shards.
Galactic issues, sweetie. Not fair to pin it on one kid.
I know.
Tell you what, I'll go have a word with this moon bear. Rough him up a little, then save the goddess. How's that? Sound good?
Oh, Daddy, that would be solar.
Yeehaw!
Ew, ow, oh, ah, oh.
Daddy?
We'll find another moon, honey.
Well, you're no help. Fine, we'll take care of it. Come on, Kataro.
And so, with newfound courage, Kutaro and Picarina descended from the brilliant center of the galaxy to once again face the dark terrors of the moon. With the help of Calibrus, Kutaro defeated the menace and saved the souls of a lucky few. Well done, Kutaro! The souls he freed were homeward bound. Kutaro had